if you're just tuning in, today we are at NERSA. Chief Sun will be playing against the University of Oregon basketball club team at UCLA. Today is the first day of the tournament. This is the first game for both teams today. Both are looking to exceed further into the tournament. I'm your host, Amber Barquita. This is brought to you by Matador Sports Network from Cal State University Northridge. For University of Oregon, there are 14 players to go. Skylar Russert, Cole Rothman, Robert Liu, Cooper Pedotti, Charles Calcote, Glenn Tangai, Jordan Holt, Ronan Ripre, Mike Lynn, David Ginsberg, Greg Allen, Nick Cavallari, and Josh Larson and Gary Chen. Coaches are head coach is Aaron Green, assistant coach Phil Richmond. For your Matadors, we have DJ Netherly, Matthew Reyes, Nico Vega, Justin Alvarado, Christian Elzy, John Inskeep, Carlos Reyes, Sam Sim, Terrence Garcia, and Jesse Contreras. The game will be starting in just a few moments as both teams check in their IDs. The CSUN Matadors have been on a losing streak for the most part this season. We're looking forward to change that up this tournament and try and go far. Later tonight, the women's basketball club team will be at 9 p.m. Again, this live stream is brought to you by Matador Sports Network from Cal State University Northridge. Thank you for tuning in. We really appreciate it. And the starting lineup for University of Oregon are number 15, Nick Cavallari, number 3, Cooper Pedotti, number 24, Gary Chen, number 4, Carol Calcote, and number 10, Jordan Holt. For CSUN Matadors starters, we have number 34, John Inskeep, 12, Matt Reyes, 5, Justin Alvarado, 11, Terrence Garcia, and Sam Sim, number 33. The game is just about to be underway. Tip off. Got to start. Again, I'm your host, Amber Partita. Get this show on the road. Tip-off was won by CSUN Matadors as Matt Reyes blows a wide-open layup. Rebound by number 4 for University of Oregon, Calcote. Calcote. Looking for someone as they seem to be doing a dribble off pass play for Oregon Ducks. Finn tries to bank it off, no good. Rebound by Finn. Finn pulls up a jumper, and it's good. Taking that, the first point of the game is 19:25 to go. Score is 2-0. Calcote bringing up the ball, setting up the play as the head coach simulates the play to go up. It's like a type of give and go to guard. As Oregon nearly turns it over. Penn tries to do a nice layup and he does. Sends it off. Off of 34 in sweep. We'll be seeing a lot of that tonight. Garcia. Alvarado to Reyes. Reyes looking for someone. Backs out. Penn goes off the screen. Shoots another jumper. This is a 3 and it's good. Making that 5-2. Calcote. Trying to answer back for Oregon. See if I'm playing some tough defense as they find number 10 in the corner. Holt, who gives it off to 10 again, once again. Misses it just by a little bit. And she needs to play tough defense in order to stop 10 early on in this game. dribble, gives it off to Inti, decides to take it up himself, and it's good, making that 7-2. Alcone gives it off to Badadi. Badadi shoots it, no good. Rebound by number 15, Cavallari, who puts it up and in. Score is now 7-4. With 17:45 left to go in the first half, as Samson pulls up a jumper, no good. Inti tries to dish it out to a player, but instead it will go off of number 4 from Oregon, Cal Poly. It will remain CSUN ball as Samson inbounds it, sideline. Finds Inti to Justin Alvarado for a 3, no good. Rebound by 10. Number 12, Matt Ray. First team foul for CSUN. Number 3, Kadadi, trying to shake off Garcia. Garcia playing tough defense. In keep. Call Cody for a 3, no good. Rebound by Inti. Garcia coming up with the ball now. Trying to call his team, set of a play as he goes off the screen. Inti was open for that, no good. Can't decide to give it himself instead of kick off the backboard. Akakodi finds number 3 wide open for a 3, dodges Garcia, but instead misses the 3. CSUN ball. Looks like Oregon's a little nervous starting off in this game. Some pre-game nerves. Samson with the ball for CSUN. Samson tries to drive it up, instead it's stripped away by number 15, Cavallari, off of his leg, so it will remain Matador ball. Samson finds Rage. Rage tries to drive it in himself, he does, misses another layup, rebound by Sam, finds Inti, Inti off to Garcia. Garcia ditches his move nicely, is able to get his own rebound off the kick from Inti. Matt Ray for a 3, no good. Rebound by Cal Cody. Cal Cody finds, that will be a turnover. Number 15, Cavallari's foot was on the line. First turnover for Oregon. As Inti does a nice reverse layup, the Duke. I see some Mariners are urging their players to talk on defense. Oregon nearly turns the ball over, and they do, as Alvarado gets the ball and puts it up and in. Making that 2 turnovers for Oregon so far in the first half. The score is 11-4, with 14 minutes and 45 seconds left to go in the first half. Oregon trying to make some answers here. Been silent for a while. As number 10 drives it in, and instead will be fouled by number 33, Samson. Samson thought he blocked him. Refs say otherwise. Number 10 for Oregon, Jordan Holt, will go to the line for 2. This is Oregon's first time at the line. First one in is good. As 2 players check in for Oregon. For number 4, Carol Calcotti, and 3, Cooper Padotti. In is now number 5, Glenn Tengai, and 13, David Ginsberg. That was a miss by Oregon, number 10, Holt, as Samson went up for a quick jumper, no good. Rebound by Oregon as number 13 comes in, driving in, tried to dish it off, no good. That'll be a turnover, make that 3. John Inti goes up for a layup, is able to roll it up and in. Ginsberg passes off to number 5. He tried to get fouled. Instead, that will be a air ball. And I thought he was fouled. Refs say no. Oregon's looking to press. But backs off rather quickly. Terrence Garcia didn't wait for the screen. Nearly turned it over. Colorado favorite, finally taking base in his tire. Stops and dribble gives it off to Garcia. Garcia does a nice spin move. Decides to do a Euro step, but it's blocked by Chen. Instead, they will call a foul. Garcia will go to the line for two. Garcia sees the first one. This is the first time Matadors are at the line as number 21 comes in for Chen. 21 is Josh Larson, excuse me. The score is 14-5 with 12:20 left to go in the first half. Jason looking energized as Garcia just misses that, rims right in and out. As number 5, Tangai, shoots an open three. Champion wasn't close enough for him, as number 10 for Oregon rebounds. He'll turn it over. Maybe not four turnovers for Oregon. Carlos Reyes will check in for Terrence Garcia, as well as Nico Vega for Matt Reyes. Alvarado will inbound the ball to Sam Thim. Finds Nico, gives it off to Enstead. Enstead decides to take it up himself. He's able to put it up, no good. Rebound by number 13, Ginsburg. Ginsburg finds Cavallari, back to Ginsburg. Gives it off to Larson to take it up against Enstead, does, and instead will get fouled by Enstead. That is the first foul on Enstead. Will be at the line for two. Sinks in the first one. Misses the second. Both Sinks teammates rebound. Samson gets it. Vega goes off the screen. Shoots an open three. No good. Kristen Elzy will now check in for Justin Alvarado. Ethan is pressing somewhat. Ginsburg finds Rothman. Rothman to Ginsburg. He shoots the three and makes it. Making the score 14-9 with 9:37 left to go in the first half. Sampson goes off the screen from Enstead. Gives a nice give and go. Instead will be fouled. Number 5 from Oregon Tangai said it wasn't him. Enstead goes to the line for two. Number 10 is checking back in, Jordan Holt for 16, Nick Cavallari. Ginsburg calls the play, tries to take it out, a bit in, instead it'll dish it out to number 10, Holt, who misses, rebound by Enstead. Vega, coming down, will be fouled, instead, by number 13, David Ginsburg. Instead, they turn it over and give it right to number 5. Glenn Tangai, Oregon, pressing. making that season's first turnover of the game. Sampson stops the dribble. And then that will be the second turnover in less than a minute. As number 13, David Ginsburg comes up for a layup and instead will be fouled by Sampson. That is Sampson's second foul of the game. Looks like we're at our first timeout of the game. Again, this is Amber Partida. Live stream is brought to you by Matador Sportsnet from Cal State and Northridge, and we'll be back in just a moment. We're back. Thank you for tuning in. This is Matador Sports Network. I'm your host, Amber Partida. Tonight we have Cal State Northridge versus University of Oregon. The score is 15 to 11 with 7. Jackson for Carlos Reyes. Garcia goes up for a layup, no good, but a foul will be called. Shooting on number 13, David Ginsburg. Terrence at the line for two. First one is good. As two new Oregon players check in, 10. And number 3, Cooper Fidati. As number 5, Glenn Tangai checks out, as well as number 10, Jordan Holt. Second free throw is no good, rims right in and out, as Netherly tries to play good defense. And a turnover, making that Oregon's fifth turnover of the first half. Good defense by the Mavericks, as Vega goes off screen by Inskeep, finds a give and go, puts it up and in, and that was a great play by both Inskeep and Vega. Houston is looking to press now, with about 2 minutes and 45 seconds left to go. Number 3 is able to save the ball to Dottie, but instead it'll be turned over, as Matt Ray is able to save the ball from going out of bounds. Netherly to Inskeep, who Terrence Garcia nearly crosses over the line, so that will be a turnover, making that Houston's third turnover of the game. Inskeep wasn't thinking. Didn't see the line. Backcourt. As Oregon's looking to inbound the ball, referee is waiting for someone. Number 16, Nick Cavallari gives it off to Rockman. He decides to try and go up for a layup. No good. Rebound by Netherly. Garcia decides to take it up himself, does a nice Euro step, but again, blows the layup. Rothman loses the ball, turnover by Oregon, as Garcia tries to net again. That is good. Redemption. He's been playing some tough defense now. Reyes on Rothman. Rothman tries to spin over, as Vega steals the ball away, making that Oregon's seventh turnover of the game, as Garcia thought about it, gives it off to Vega, besides Matt Ray. Matt Ray goes by his defender, but nearly turns it over, and does. As number 15 is fouled by Netherly. Cavallari at the line for two. Score is 26-12 with a minute and 9 seconds left to go in the first half. As Cavallari looking for the first attempt, number 4 checks in Carl Calcote, for number 31, Cole Rothman for Oregon. Houston has a comfortable lead going into the second half. As Cavallari rumbles in his second free throw attempt. Matt Reyes to Garcia. Garcia to a wide open Sam Sim. No good. Tendai to Chen. Chen shoots the 3. No good. Rebound by Alvarado. 45 seconds in counting. 26-13. Houston on top. Houston is trying to use the remainder of the clock time, throwing some dangerous passes there that could easily be intercepted by Oregon. Inskeep loses the ball and does. Number 5. And they'll be calling a block on Samson, making that his third foul of the game. He needs to be careful. 9 times out of 10, that will always be a block rather than a charge. he would have backed off just a little bit, it's possible that he could have made him travel. But instead, it is 1-1 now. CSUN is over the limit with their foul. As Glenn Tangai is at the line. They'll substitute count him out to make sure he doesn't get any remainder fouls. Nico Vega subs in for him. 1-1. Tangai misses it. Garcia with the rebound. 20 seconds left in counting as Nico Vega thought about it. Alvarado. Garcia looks at the clock. 10 seconds left. 8 and counting. 7, 6, 5, 4. Alvarado for 3. And it's good. The score is 29-13. Making that an exciting first half of the game. CSUN with a commanding lead over Oregon. Thank you for tuning in. This is Matador Sports Network. I'm your host, Amber Partida, and we'll be back in just a moment to go over the first half stats.
but it's already, halftime's already over. That's why I was like, I need you back over here.
Oh, sorry.
So you can double click Sisa right there. Do we double click
it? I needed, that's why I just want the total, okay. Like, LZ 3 points, 5 points, 4 points, okay. 5 points, and then I need the other team too. And we're back, and we'll get those stats to you in just a moment. Having some technical difficulties. Second half is about to start. The score is 29-13. CSUN Matadors are winning over University of Oregon. CSUN won the tip-off, so it will be Oregon ball. Number 14, Allen, and will inbound the ball for Oregon. Kyle Cody looking to set a play up. Finds Allen. Allen to Kyle Cody for the three, no good. Rebound by CSUN. Samthin coming down. Samthin goes off to us. We're not open though. Wrong people. Turnover. Oregon looking to make an answer early in the second half as number 15 tries to put it up and in. No good. Rebound by Inskeep. Oregon needs to start off strong in the second half if they want to get back into this game. Inskeep for three, no good. Rebound by Holt. Holt nearly loses his balance, and it will be backcourt, making that the first turnover for Oregon in the second half. And I'll get to you on these stats right now. LZ for CSUN scored 3 points. Alvarado, 5 points. Garcia, 2 points. Thim, 5 points. Inskeep, 9 points. Vega, 3 points. As Inskeep goes up for a layup, tries to put it up and in, no good. It was touched by Oregon, so it's CSUN ball. Oregon looking a little frustrated right now. Samthin will inbound the ball. Baseline. Dishes it out to Garcia. Almost get caught up by Holt. Garcia decides to take it up and in himself, no good. Instead, they'll turn it over. Oregon will turn it over. Samthin stole the ball. Tried to dish it off the backboard, no good. Number 14 coming in strong, but is blocked by Matt Reyes. Allen was denied by Reyes. Reyes decides to take it up and in himself, and it's good. Score is now 31-13 with 17 minutes left to go in this game. Cal Cody. Finds Cavallari, shoots a three, no good. Rebound by Garcia. Oregon stats for the first half. Tanguy has 2 points. Holt, 1 point. Ginsburg, 4 points. Cavallari, 3 points. Larson, 1 point. And Chen, 2 points. Matt Reyes, open for the three, no good. Rims in and out, but Inskeep is there to rebound it. Foul. It will be a charge on Inskeep. Subs coming in. Chen coming in for number 14. Greg Allen for Oregon. Ronan Ripperay will inbound the ball baseline for Oregon. Cal Cody. Trying to command his team. Make a play happen as he stops his dribble. Ripperay to Chen. Chen. Cal Cody for three. Rims right in and out. Rebound by Sam Thim. Matt Reyes decides to take it up and in himself, and it's good. Oregon needs to answer in order to get back in this game. The margin is now through 20 points. Season covers the ball. Samson doesn't wait for the screen. Gives it off to Matt Reyes. Matt Reyes goes up and in again, rims out, but Johnskeep tries to get the rebound. Couldn't hang on to it. Rip Ray gives it off to Cal Cody. Cal Cody to Holt. Rip Ray decides to take it up and in, not contested, and scores, making that their first basket of the second half. Garcia coming in strong, finds Matt Reyes for an open three, and it's good. Making that 36-15 with 15 minutes and 20 seconds left to go in the game. Oregon needs to answer back quickly as Cavallari finds Holt for an easy basket. Oregon's trying to press. Seems like not everyone's on the same page though. Matt Reyes tries to take it up and in. Wanted a foul called. As Holt takes it up and in again, once more. Garcia double team, stops his dribble, turns it over. And Oregon is making that comeback. Score is now 36-21. As a foul will be called on number 34, John Inskeep. Season checks in two players, Carlos Reyes and Nico Vega. Season is looking a little flustered now by Oregon, scoring back-to-back shots. Nico Vega. Nico Vega shoots the long three, no good. Rims right in and out, number 13. David Ginsburg gets the rebound. Oregon trying to make that comeback. Padotti. Ginsburg. To Chen. Chen tries to bank it off. No good. Rims right in and out. Carlos Reyes almost lost it out of bounds. Recovers. Thim. Stops his dribble. Inskeep to Vega. Vega thought about it. Stops his dribble. Alvarado to Reyes. And it's good, making that 39-21 with 13 minutes left to go in the game. CSUN on top. Ginsburg. Rip Ray decides to take it up and in himself and will get fouled along the way by number 5, Justin Alvarado. Although CSUN may be up by a significant amount of points, this game is definitely a thriller. A lot of action going on. Rip Ray makes his first one at the line. No, they got it. Rip Ray puts in both. Oregon doing a double trap at the corners. Tisa nearly turns it over, Vega. And they do turn it over, excuse me. Now CSUN is getting flustered by Oregon's defense. Padotti trying to look for Chen, does. Ball was poked by Inskeep. Sam Thim recovers the ball for CSUN. And that going to the line for a 3-point opportunity. Sub coming in for Oregon, number 5, Glenn Tangai. For number 11, Ronan Ripperay. as Sam Thin has the chance to make this a three-point opportunity. Score is 41-23 with 11 minutes left in this game. And he completes the three-point opportunity. Tanguy. The ball gets poked away by Sam Thim as Tanguy tries to foul him. Instead, a timeout will be called by CSUN in order to remain coverage of the ball. Score is 42-23 with 10:56 left to go in the game. First timeout for CSUN in the second half. And we'll be right back. And we're back. Thank you for tuning in. This is Matador Sports Network, brought to you by Cal State University Northridge. I'm your host, Amber Partida. As we have CSUN Matador's men's basketball club team against University of Oregon. CSUN inbounding the ball sideline as Elzy, looking for a player, finds Vega. Vega shoots the wide open three. He likes to shoot from far, and he scores, making that 45-23. CSUN on top. Although, again, like I said, they may be winning by a lot. This game is definitely an aggressive one. Missed attempt by number three, Padotti. Rebound by CSUN. Elzy stops his dribble, trying to look for someone. Finds Carlos Reyes, who tries to take it up in himself. No good. Tipped out by Chen. Rebound by number five, Tanguy, who shoots a three, and it's good, making that 26 now for Oregon. Carlos Reyes finds Elzy, nearly loses the ball, dishes it off to Vega, defended by 13, Ginsburg. Carlos Reyes for three, no good. Rebound controlled by Carlos Reyes, but his foot was stepped out of bounds. That will be turnover number four for CSUN. Fourth one in the second half, that is. Eight overall. Ginsburg. Tanguy. Back to Ginsburg. Tries to go off the screen, instead stops his dribble, finds Chen. Chen trying to back off on Inscape, does a nice reverse, and it's good. I'm surprised they haven't been doing that most of the game. Chen is definitely bigger when it comes to it. Chen tries to go for the steal, misses, costly mistake, allowing Elzy to score an easy bucket. Tanguy. Rebound by CSUN. Carlos Reyes stops his dribble, but is able to give it off to Sam Thim. Sam Thim tries to shake off his defender, who tries to do it up in the layup, but is unable to. Oregon ball. Three subs will now be coming in for Oregon. Number 31, Cole Rothman. 11, Ronan Ripperay. And 15, Nick Cavallari. Ginsburg to Rothman. A foul will be called on Oregon. Seems as though a defender was trying to set a screen and pushed off on Elzy. Sam Thim will be coming out. Matt Reyes will replace him. 7:40 and counting left to go in the game. Oregon, still pressuring on defense. Elzy shoots the three, and it's good, making it now 50-28, CSUN. Rothman stops his dribble, gives it off to Ginsburg. To Cavallari for three, no good. Rebound by Netherly. Matt Reyes coming down for CSUN. Who tries to dish it off the backboard, no good. Netherly tried to rebound it, came a little too early. Ginsburg coming down for Oregon. Bray stops his dribble, gets caught up, turns it over. Vega with the ball and is fouled along the way. He'll be going to the line for two as number 13, Ginsburg. Trying to get an explanation as to why that was a foul. Vega at the line for two. First one is good, as number four checks in for Oregon, Cal Cody. 15 checks out, Nick Cavallari. As Vega misses his second free throw attempt, rebound by Rothman. Oregon trying to push it, 6 minutes left to go in the game. Trying to make a comeback quickly, Cal Cody. Dishes it off. Instead, that will be a turnover. Bounce right off of Rip Ray's leg. Making that three turnovers for Oregon in the second half. 10 turnovers overall in the game for Oregon. As Matt Reyes comes down for CSUN. Finds Elzy. Elzy thought about it. He'll take it in and will be fouled by number 13, Ginsburg. Elzy at the line for two. Those are two quick fouls on Ginsburg. Elzy misses his first attempt. Score is 51-28 with 4 minutes and 50 seconds left in this game and counting. As Elzy makes his second attempt. The time only is a stop and go at the 2 minute mark when it is not above a 10 deficit. In this case, that won't happen. Rip Ray looking for someone. Finds Lynn, who checked in just now. Cal Cody finds a wide open layup as Matt Reyes tries to play lazy. Alvarado nearly turns it over. Elzy steps out of bounds, making that CSUN's fifth turnover of the game. Jesse Contreras comes in for Matt Reyes. Oregon ball. Ginsburg puts it up and in quickly. Oregon trying to play quick ball here as they D up Vega. Tried to give it off to Netherly. Too fast of a pass. Turnover number six for CSUN. Oregon. Ginsburg coming down with the ball. Does a nice shake and bake. Gives it off to number 34, Russert, who puts it up and in. Making the score now 52-34. 3 minutes left to go in the game. CSUN on top. Live stream is brought to you by Matador Sports Network. I'm your host, Amber Partida. Vega is fouled. By number 34, Skylar Russert. his first foul of the game. Vega will inbound the ball sideline. Netherly, blocked by Ripperay. Rothman nearly lost the ball, guarded by Alvarado, finds Ripperay. He gets it stolen by Contreras. Contreras coming up for a layup and puts it up and in, making that his first basket of the game. Score is now 54-34 with 2 minutes left to go. Rothman for the two. No good. Rebound by Netherly. Alvarado finds Vega. Shoots it over Rothman. No good. Rebound by Russert. Rothman for three. Rims right in and out as CSUN remains coverage with the ball. 1 minute, 30 seconds left to go in the game. Elzy decides to take it up in himself. Almost got his own rebound. Ginsburg said recovers. Russert finds it wide open. Number 12, that was Lynn for three, no good. A foul instead will be called on Netherly. Or excuse me, number 11, Ripperay from Oregon. CSUN ball. 55 seconds left to go. Seems as though CSUN will be coming on top for this one, making that their first win of the tournament. Timeout will be called by CSUN. The score is 54-34 with 41 seconds left to go. We'll stay live. Again, the live stream is brought to you by Matador Sports Network. I'm your host, Amber Partita. Thank you for tuning in for this one. Next time we'll be live will be at 9 p.m. for the women's game. We'll also be playing the season's men and women's games tomorrow morning at the NERSA tournament held at UCLA. CSUN will inbound the ball, perhaps for the final time of this game, with a commanding 20-point lead. Vega gives it off to Elzy. Elzy double-teamed, turns it over, but a foul will be called. Push off from number 31, Rothman from Oregon. Not in the bonus quite yet, so CSUN will inbound the ball sideline. 18 seconds and counting. Vega needs to get over. Looks like they're going to waste the time with 3 seconds left to go. And it looks like that will be game. The score is 54-34. CSUN comes out on top on this one over the University of Oregon. Thank you for tuning in. We'll be back in just a moment to go over the final stats. If you're just tuning in, we just concluded the first game for CSUN men's basketball club team. They are victorious over University of Oregon. Final score was 44-34. Going over the final stats now. For CSUN, Christian Elzy had 9 points overall, Alvarado with 5, Carlos Reyes with 3, Garcia with 4, Thim with 9 points, Matt Reyes with 7 points, Contreras with 2 points, Inskeep with 9 points, and Vega with 7 points. CSUN had 10 turnovers overall. For Oregon, for Cal Cody had 6 points, Tangai 5 points, Holt 1 point, Ripperay 6 points, Ginsburg 6 points, Cavallari 3 points, Larson 1 point, Chen 4 points, and Russert 2 points. And they also had 10 turnovers overall. Thank you for tuning in. This live stream is brought to you by Matador Sports Network. I'm your host, Amber Partida. We'll be checking back in around 8:50 p.m. for the women's basketball club team's game. This NERSA tournament is held at UCLA this year. Thank you again for tuning in, and we'll be back shortly.